Applauding Life After 50 on BCTV is underwritten by White Star Travel Center.
Applauding Life After 50. I'm Kathy Roberts. I'm the health and wellness educator for Berks Encore. This is our second exercise session of our Movement is Medicine program. In this session, I decided to focus on upper body strength. We're always working our legs and hips to get better balance and reduce falls. We always do. We get stronger with our legs all the time. But it wasn't until I started to work in the garden and lift those heavy bags of mulch that I realized I had lost upper body strength. So I thought we'd focus on some exercises today to get more flexible upper body and get stronger upper body. Okay. But for today, you're going to need some toys. We're going to need equipment to do that. So the first thing you're going to need is you're going to need weights. And I like to use water bottles. And let me explain to you why. A water bottle, and I like to use a water bottle that I say has a waist. See, has a waist. Why? Because I can grab it. Straight water bottle, I might not be able to grab. I don't have really big hands, so I can grab this. Now, you can use your soup cans. But we all know what's going to happen. Murphy's Law, you're going to hold that soup can, it's going to slip out of your hand, and guess where it's going to land? Right on your toe, and that's going to sting. So I suggest using the water bottles. The second piece of equipment you're going to use, is the yardstick. Don't get scared. You're not going to get paddled. You know how we got paddled when we were kids. We're actually going to use this to do upper body. If you don't have a yardstick, which most of you probably do, I don't know. I don't think my mother ever used this to measure. You can use a broom because guess what? The bottom of this broom comes off. See? Broom. Now you could use a cane, but that's going to be lopsided depending on even on the handle. So I suggest something straight. Okay, and always we're going to need a chair without arms, sneakers, and water. Because we take sip breaks. And if you recall from last time, why do we take sip breaks? Because as we age, we lose our sense of thirst. So by the time we're thirsty, we're dehydrated. So we're going to take our sippy breaks. Okay, so a good exercise program will always consist of a warm-up stretch, aerobic to get your heart pumping and get your blood through your system and strength. So let's get started by warming up stretching. So if you remember from last time, is to stand with your feet apart. You don't want to stand with your feet together. Whoop, there you go, over you go. We don't want to fall. So we want to stand comfortably, our feet a little bit pronated out, usually about 2 feet apart. Now I have a good base. Can't knock me over, right? And we're going to reach up again, like you're going to touch that ceiling. Oh, my belly doesn't stick out. That wouldn't be good. And we're going to turn to our right, turn as far as you can. Now you want to turn your head, your shoulders, your hips. Come center, turn to the left, twist, 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 twist. Keep reaching up. Come center, now palms out to the side, and just clouds down. Doesn't that feel good? We should wake up like that every morning. Okay, now we're going to do shoulder rows, not shrugs. We're going to go around, and we're going to do both shoulders at the same time. 10 front, 10 back. Here we go. Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4 big circles, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Forward, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now we're going to do our chest pull. We're going to stretch that chest because, again, we're going to do our upper body, so we need to stretch it out. So the best way for me to show this to you is from the side. We're going to clasp our hands behind our back. And we're going to stand up big and tall like your mom would like. And then we're going to pull our arms away from our body. And we're going to hold that count with me for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Stand up straight. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Notice I skipped some numbers there. Okay, that's all right. Now we're going to do arm circles because we are going to work with our arms today. Now we're going to do big circles. If you have a bad shoulder, remember what I told you. Bend all the way over and stir the pot if you have a frozen shoulder or a rotator cuff issue. Okay? So, right arm up, 8 front, 8 back. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Back. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Left arm. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Other direction. One, two. We're doing the back thing. Four, five, six, seven, eight. It's like doing the swim, right? Remember the old swim dance? Okay, now let's take a sip because we're going to do our aerobic walking. Okay, oh, that tastes good. Okay, so we're going to start with an easy walk, right? Walk, two, three, four, walk, two, three, four. Now, if you remember last time, we did what I call promenade or Virginia reel. We're going to go front, two, three, four, back. Two, three, four. Front, two, three, four. Back, two, three, four. Front, two, three, four. Back, two, three, four. And walk. And walk. Now let's do some kicks. And kick, and twist. And kick, and kick. And kick, and kick. If you can twist, that's good. Kick, and 10, and 9, and 8, and 7, and 6, and 5, and 4. And three, and two, and one. And walk, and walk. Front, two, three, four. Back, two, three, four. Front, two, three, four. Back, two, three, four. Front, two, three, four. Back, two, three, four. And walk. You know, walking backwards is really a good thing for balance and also for your hamstrings. Now we're going to do some arms, okay? Arms up. To the side, down. Keep walking. Up, side, down. Up, side, down. Two more. Up, side, down. One more. Up, side, down. Okay? And promenade last time. Front, two, three, four. Back, two, three, four. Front, two, three, four. Back, two, three, four. And walk. Now we're going to do march to a count of 20. And when we march, now we're going to really get at it. We're going to lift our knees up and swing our arms, okay? One, two, three, four. Get them up. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Slow it down. Slow it down. And breathe. And stop. And sit, because we're going to get our chair and our tools. Now don't be shocked, because I'm actually going to, we're going to do almost everything in the chair. Bet you never thought you'd hear me tell you to sit. You're used to hearing me say, get out of that chair, get up. Today is a little different. So we're going to sit in our chair. And when we sit, if you remember, you want to sit on the edge. The elastic to my underwear is kind of on the end. My feet are back. Now, last time we did rowing, bent over rowing, right? We're going to do the same thing, but this time we're going to use our stick, our paddling stick. Now, in order to do that, remember, you got to get your back flat and your head down. So you need to spread your legs because some of us have more than others. You need to get this stuff down in the middle. So here I go. I'm down. The yardstick is in front of me, but my hands are on the outside of my ankles. My back is flat. Let's do two verses of row your boat. And pull hard. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Pull hard. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Again, row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Good job. Stick to the side, okay? Now we're going to do, oh, wait a minute. No, we're not. We're going to still use that stick. We're going to do a military press, okay? So what we're going to do, we're going to start here in the front. We're going to go up, then we're going to go to the back. Then we're going to go up and front, okay? So here we go. Up and back, up and front. Up and back, up and front. Sit up tall, up and back, up and front, up and back, up and front, up and back. Not easy. Up and front, up and back. One more. Up and front, and up and back. Good job. Okay, now we're going to do chest flies. And in order to do that, see how, I don't know if you can see from here, but my feet are flat on the ground. I'm on the edge, and I'm going to take my water bottles, my weights, and I'm going to lean back and get my chest out, stick my arms straight out, and I'm going to fly. These are called chest flies, like if you had dumbbells. One, two, three, four. My head's up looking at the ceiling. Five, six, seven, eight. Keep going. Nine. Come on. 10, 11. Now it's going to get harder. 12, 13, 14. Come on. 15. You can do it. 16, 17. Come on. 18, 19, 20. Woo! Good job. It's really funny with that one. You think after you do 10, well, that was easy. And then it gets a little harder. Okay. So now we're going to sit up. Still have my water bottles. And we're going to do laterals. And laterals look like this. Not this. You don't want to go above shoulder, above arm height. Ready? We're going to do 15 of these. Here we go. Sit up big and tall. One. Two. Three. Four, five, six, come on, seven, you can do it, eight, nine, ten, the last five are the what, five, four, three, come on, you can do it, two, one. Isn't it funny how when you count backwards, it doesn't seem as long? Okay, last one for our upper body is, of course, our chair twist. Now, remember what I told you, that 65% of car accidents involving older adults are because you're too stiff and you can't turn. You rely on your side mirrors or your rear view mirrors to see cars coming, and that's not good enough. You need to be able to turn and look. So what we're going to do is we're going to sit on the edge, hands on our thighs, and we're going to stick our right arm straight up, right? And then we're going to turn to the right, turn, 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 turn. Now you want to turn that you're all the way back. Turn your head, your chest, and your waist, and hold that for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, come on, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Now the key here is to sit up straight. See, if you slouch and go like this, the chair's in your way. And you can go further if you sit up straight. So, let's sit up straight. Let's do the left. See how good and straight I am? My arms straight out, and I'm turning to the left. Turn, 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 turn. I'm all the way around. Nice and straight. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Now, if you did this right, you should actually feel a little pull in the back of your shoulder. So it's not just for your ability to turn, it's also giving you an arm workout and an upper body workout as well. Okay, so let's take a sip break, just a quickie, quickie sippy. Okay, now we're going to do work our lower body. See, you thought we weren't going to do that today, but there's no exercise program that you don't work your lower body, work your legs. So we're going to do it, but we're going to do it in the chair, okay? And we're going to end with a very special challenge exercise. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to do toe raises. Now, I hope that you can see me. See how my feet are? Remember what we did at standing? We're going to go up as high as we can on tiptoes, and I'm sitting on the edge, but I'm going to bend over and actually press my hands down on my knees. So I'm going to push up on my toes and press down on my knees, and hold that for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Whew! You're using your own body and your own strength for resistance against your toe raises. Okay? So now we're going to do what I call knee lifts. And again, we're sitting on the edge, and we're going to lift our knee up as high as we can. Key here is my foot is flexed, because when you flex your foot, you get a strong tightness in your muscle. What you're not going to do is hit the floor, because the pop off the floor is cheating. So we're going to do 15. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, other leg. That's a burner, isn't it? You feel it in here. Other leg, here we go. 1, 2, keep that foot flexed. 3, 4, don't touch the ground. 5, 6, 7, 8, come on. 9, 10, 11, 12, get that heart pumping. 13, 14, 15. You can do that watching TV, you know. Highly recommended. Okay, now we're going to do our foot circles. And remember, no legs moving. We're just drawing a circle with our big toe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Other direction. Whee! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You hear it cracking. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job. Left foot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Other direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You know, I just realized when I was doing that, I had a little burn in the back of my foot. This is called your heel cord, and that gets tight when it's not exercised a lot. And quite frankly, I haven't been doing my due diligence either exercising with this pandemic, and I realized that my heel cord is tight. It's always tight on my left foot for whatever reason. It's probably because I'm right-handed. Okay, so now we're going to take a sip, and we're going to do our special challenge exercise. For this exercise, your chair must be against the wall, okay? These are called sit-to-stands. And what you're going to do is you're going to sit on the edge again, but you're going to tuck your feet behind your knees. And we're going to cross our arms, stand up, sit down, stand up, sit down. And I know it sounds crazy, but we're going to do 20 of them. But I'm going to give you some ideas if you can't do them all 20 like I just did. First of all, what we're not going to do is do this, because that's cheating. You keep your feet flat on the ground. But what you can do is if you can't get up, bend over. Because when you bend over, guess what happens? Your hiney comes off the chair. Also, if you start to lose strength, push off your legs. Use your legs and push off. Just don't quit. See if you can stay with me and do 20. Okay? So, great to practice. If you can't, just keep trying. So we're going to do 20. Are you ready? Arms crossed. Here we go. Stand up and also sit down. Now, when you're doing this, that's 2, sit down. 3, stand up all the way. Sit down. 4, sit down. 5, sit down. It's easier to do it. Get in rhythm. Sit down. 7, sit down. People are laughing at me here. 8, sit down. 9, sit down. 10, sit down. We're halfway. 11, sit down. 12, sit down. 13, sit down. 14, sit down. 15, sit down. Here we go. Home stretch. 5, down. 4, down. 3, down. 2, down. Last one. Woo! Woo! If you did 20, I don't care how you did them, that's a great job. I am so proud of you. If you do those every day, you'll get stronger and stronger. Remember, these are your independence muscles. Now, guess what? We're done. It's time to cool down. So, and we're going to do the cool down in the chair too. Woo, isn't it a great day? Okay, so we want to sit on the edge. And if you remember last time, we did, I called it the Raggedy Ann and Andy stretch. It was for our hamstrings. We're also going to stretch our calf and our hamstring. Now, I keep telling you to count with me, and you're probably thinking, why does she say that? Well, I'll tell you why I say it. Because when you stretch, people have a tendency to hold their breath. I don't want you to hold your breath. And if you're counting with me, you can't hold your breath. Also, no bouncing. Okay? So we stick our right foot straight out. The key here is that your toe is pulled back. Up we go. Here comes Floppy, Raggedy Ann, and Andy. Gently go down and hold that with me. Count with me. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Keep that toe pulled back. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Now don't do this. If anything, try to reach the floor. You'll find that after 10, you can probably go a little further. Okay? Left leg, left foot out, toe pulled back, arms up, whoop, elevator going down. Here we go. Flop down. 2, 3, 4. That's a burner. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Ooh, what's with the left leg? I don't know. I guess we're all getting older, aren't we? But we're still strong and we're still flexible. Okay, now we're going to do our seated warrior one. If you remember this one, I have my left hand on the chair and I slide my left leg to the end and then my right leg goes down and back. Look at that beautiful L shape and I'm up on my toe. And I'm holding on. And then I'm going back. Head up to the ceiling, count with me, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. That's a biggie stretch. That felt good. Okay, don't even have to get up. Look, I'm walking around, all right? Right arm on the chair, hold on. I use my elbow to block myself from leaning in, that would be cheating. My right leg is on the end. My left leg goes down and back in a beautiful L. I'm up on my toe. I'm holding on. Here I go. Count with me. 2, 3, 4, 5. Look at the ceiling. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Well, there we go. Okay. Now we're going to stand up. We're in the home stretch. So, better push this chair out of the way so I don't fall. Okay. All right, so now we're going to stand, reach, and twist. Again, 2 feet apart, okay? And we're going to reach up to the sky, and we're going to thank the Lord for this wonderful day that we could be together. And we're going to turn to the left, twist all the way, right? Come back, twist all the way to the right, come back, reach up. Now, this is going to be a shoulder stretch. I want you to clasp your hands like you're praying. And now pull your elbows back behind your ears and hold that count with me for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now bring it forward and down slowly. Namaste. Okay, and last but not least, we're gonna do a nice Tai Chi breath. Remember that one? Big breath in through your nose, and slow 10 seconds out through your mouth. Ready? Here we go. Big breath. Let's do that again. That felt good. Here we go. One more time. You know, this is also good if you're stressed. There are times when I'm at home and certain individuals do get on my nerves and I have to run into the kitchen and I do this Tai Chi breathing and it seems to work for me. I don't know. Try it. Here we go. Ready? It's a shame you can't do that in the car. I think you might get in a car accident. But you can do the slow breathing if you're stuck in traffic. Okay, that's it for today. I thank you so much for joining me. What I recommend for you is to alternate our first session, then this session, and do that 2 to 3 times a week. That way you'll get a whole body strength and stretch and stronger and more flexible. Stay tuned for our next exercise program when we're going to target better balance. These programs will repeat on BCTV. Also, they will be available on YouTube and on our Berks Encore Facebook page. Remember, movement is medicine. Stay safe, stay connected, and stay strong. Thank you.